The recording for this podcast is brought to you by the good folks from goodpoliticsradio.com. Thank you for listening.
Thank you for listening to the Talkstar Radio Network. For the finest and informative and interactive talk radio programming, it's the Talkstar Radio Network, available live via your local radio station and on the internet at talkstarradio.com. Your feedback is important to us. Email us at talkstarradio.com.
Chuck Harder.
Everybody, Chuck Harder, attorney Ray Boreas of the law firm of Boreas and Wolfson in San Francisco, California, is kind enough to give us some of his time. Counselor, are you there?
Yes, I am. Thank you very much for the opportunity to talk to your listeners.
Appreciate it, and I understand you've got a book out called Insult to Injury. Give us, if you would, from an attorney's view of what happens next in this tragedy.
Well, the what I want to have happen next is to see some reforms enacted in Congress and in the state legislatures, which I don't think is unrealistic under the circumstances. The reason I say that is this. What we have is a situation where everyone in the United States who gets their insurance at work, health or disability, unless they are in a very narrow category of exempted employment, such as they work for the government or they work for a religious organization. Those are the only two major exceptions. Everybody else, if you work for a newspaper, for a steel mill, for any kind of a bank or any kind of business or industry at all, if you get your insurance through work, and the insurance company defaults you out of your benefits, flat out defaults you.
Yeah, you're talking about ERISA, like happened to me with an organization called Humana, where they just simply let me down after I had been paying for years and I couldn't sue them. Is that what you're talking
That's
about?
That's exactly right. And people don't realize this, but if they defraud you, and you even if you're bankrupted, you lose your house, everything is lost. As it would happen with Joan Handgutter. She lost all of her personal belongings, put them in storage, couldn't afford to pay the bill. They sold all of that. She was bankrupted. She was destitute. She had to declare bankruptcy. She wound up on food stamps with her two children, a single mother. Even if all of that stuff happens to you, and the insurance company, even if they admit that they defrauded you, you can't sue them for fraud. You can't collect a dime for any of those things.
That's right. I know. You're talking to a man who's been through it.
It's unbelievable, and people don't realize this, and there's no justification for it whatsoever. The reason we have that is because of the lobbying of the insurance industry and because people don't know what's going on. They don't realize what happened to their protections.
Well, my case is a parallel of the case of CHIP, CHIPPS versus Humana, if you look it up on the Internet. CHIPS, CHIPPS versus Humana.
All right.
Exact parallel. Even involved leg braces. But the point of it is that, I got stonewalled by Humana for 3 months before they even looked at my broken leg.
Oh, boy.
I mean,
well, with Joan, just to give you an example, I mean, we had countless plaintiffs like this, people with spinal injuries, with organic brain damage, with very serious injuries, obviously disabling injuries, and they took these people and they took a select number of them. They're not stupid enough to take the whole kit and caboodle of every claimant that they've got. They understand that just by getting away with this with a couple of thousand people a year, you're going to boost profits by hundreds of millions of dollars. And so by targeting a small number of claimants like this, percentage-wise, perhaps they get 120,000 long-term disability claims a year, and you take 2,000 or 3,000 that you get away with terminating in a group that size. If the average claim, just to walk you through the numbers, if you take the average claim, it's worth $4,000 a month, round that out at $50,000 a year, and the person's got 10 years left between age 55 and age 65 that they're entitled to their benefits, if the insurance company gets away with terminating that claim, they're going to save $100 million a year on 2,000 claims. $100 million a year times 10 years, $1 billion. And that's just on this year's terminations. They got a whole new batch next year and the year after that and the year after that. So, and that's only 2,000 claims out of 120, 130, 150,000 long-term disability claims. Some of these companies, like Unum Provident, get 400,000 claims a year. So the company always turns around and they say, well, we pay most of our claims, which is like Jesse James saying, I didn't rob most of the banks. They don't have to cut off most of the people in order to be able to reap those benefits. And when a company does something like this, they drag down the standards for the entire industry because everybody's got to compete with that kind of nonsense. And that's what's going on. That's what's going on all over the United States.
It is the entire matter. It is beyond criminal, in my opinion. Because if you do the research like I did, and you find out the executives of these insurance companies, they have private jets. Their jets have private bedrooms. They live literally like sultans. They live like oil sheikhs.
They do.
And they are not answerable to anyone. They just simply are bulletproof.
They're bulletproof because you're absolutely right. They're bulletproof. They have errors and omissions insurance, directors and officers liability insurance, indemnification agreements with the stockholders, meaning that if anything happens, the stockholders wind up holding the bag. And when you have a situation where you have all these financial incentives on one side, the private jets and the golden parachutes, and all this, all these stock options that Alan Greenspan called, an infectious greed that is now that we're now living with in America.
Counselor,
hold that on one side.
We got to do a 2-minute break. We'll be right back, right after this.
If you have more than $7,500 in credit card debt, listen to these shocking facts. Debt can ruin your life. A great number of all marriages end in divorce due to financial problems. Many American families are only a few paychecks away from bankruptcy. There are secret programs that credit card companies don't want you to know about that will eliminate your debt. If you are drowning in credit card debt, there is a way out. Debt Relief of America can negotiate directly with your creditors to eliminate up to 60% of your credit card debt. Learn how to avoid bankruptcy and get more cash in your pocket. Call Debt Relief of America for a free debt analysis by one of their debt relief specialists. There is absolutely no cost or obligation. Call 800-936-1264. 800-936-1264. For your free information, call now. 800-936-1264. 800-936-1264.
Welcome to Straight Talk with Dr. Barry Sears. Dr. Sears, there's a history of depression in my family. What can I do?
Well, depression, we know, is really a disease caused by decreased levels of serotonin in the brain. We have many drugs that increase serotonin, but we have another nutritional product that also helps that, and that is called fish oil, containing long-chain omega-3 fatty acids. It doesn't say don't take your drugs, but fish oil makes the drugs work better.
The best way to add essential omega-3 fatty acids to your diet is by supplementing with Dr. Barry Sears' ultra-potent, ultra-clean, pharmaceutical-grade Omega-RX fish oil. To order your fish oil today, call 800-962-0123, 800-962-0123, or visit cleanfishoil.com. Call now for Omega-RX fish oil, 800-962-0123, or visit cleanfishoil.com today. Today.
Attorney Ray Boris with us of the law firm of Boris and Wolfson in San Francisco. Counselor, I even tried to get a big law firm to go after Humana on the theory that they had been taking premiums from our small nonprofit organization to guard my health, and I was the president. And then when it came time for them to honor their contract, they did not. And I wanted to go after them for contract fraud and civil fraud.
Right.
And even though we had everything to prove that, I couldn't get a law firm to take the case.
No, because you're going to get thrown right out of court.
Yeah.
And not only are you going to get thrown out of court, but you're going to have to pay their legal fees for having sued them. I mean, that's justice, right?
I'm talking.
They defraud you, and you have to pay their legal fees.
I'm not talking about me suing them personally. I'm talking about the corporation.
No, I understand. I understand exactly what you mean.
Yeah.
The corporation has to wind up paying their legal fees.
Yeah.
Because you cannot sue for fraud, bad faith, unfair trade practices, or anything to recover the losses that you or the other employees suffer as a result of being defrauded. It's absolutely unbelievable. People do not realize this. I'll tell you, you know, a lot of people say, well, you know, this is just, I'm a Democrat, okay, so I'm a registered Democrat. So people say, wow, it's only the Democrats complaining about the Republicans. That's not true. First of all, I think we're going to get a lot of support on Capitol Hill from Republicans as well as Democrats. Second of all, most of my clients and most of the people who are suffering these long-term disability terminations are probably Republican because they're people who own their own businesses. As you were saying, it's the corporations that are employing people that don't like what's going on. And this cuts across the political spectrum, liberal, conservative, Republican, Democrat. All of those people are getting handed their in a suit case. And it is outrageous that this goes on. And it happens not only at the federal level with the ERISA preemption, but in Joan Hangarter's case, one of the women that the book is about, Insult to Injury, in her case, they thought she was ERISA preempted, and they wrote her a letter to that effect. And she gave up, and she took her little family, her kids, and went down 300 miles away to move in with her sister because she didn't have any money. She had lost all of her savings, and she had no place to go and nothing to do. And she felt like she couldn't sue, she couldn't do anything. And then one day, she looked on the kitchen table. Her sister subscribed to the Wall Street Journal down in Southern California, and the paper was open, and there was a story about lawsuits against the Unemployment Insurance Company and the allegations that we were making. So she called us up and said, hey, wait a second, this is what happened to me. It turned out that the company was lying to her about being ERISA preempted. She was not. She had a group policy, but not through employment. And so we were able to file a lawsuit, and because California has good laws, we were able to win this tremendous victory for her. But that doesn't help everybody else. That doesn't help all the ERISA preempted folks. It doesn't help people who live in states that don't have strong insurance protections for people, and most states do not because of the lobbying activities of the insurance industry. So the whole situation, people talk about Enron, that's nothing compared to what's going on in the insurance industry, and the insurance industry, of course, affects everyone with a policy, not just the employees of the company or a handful of their stockholders. It affects everybody.
It's even worse now. Look, let me tell you what I just found out personally. I just personally found out by going, I went into a for-profit hospital's outpatient laboratory to get stuck for a blood test, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm talking to the intake clerk. And she said, Mr. Harder, that'll be $1,296. And I said, for a blood test that I can get at $81 at any walk-in clinic here in town? Well, she said, that's our price for the uninsured. I said, no, I have Blue Cross Blue Shield. Oh, she said, well, that and your urine test will be $116. So anyhow, I paid my $116. And then I get a bill from the hospital a little bit later for another $108, which I got because I'm on the radio and because of the fact I'm a consumer advocate and I wrote them a strong letter, they just simply blew that away. But had I been anybody else, I would have paid the extra $108. But I found out that they, like other hospitals, have three different price schedules. They have a price schedule if you are uninsured and brought in an ambulance, they have or show up. They have another price schedule if you pay cash in advance, and then another price schedule if you have Blue Cross Blue Shield.
Which is the highest?
The highest is if you are uninsured and brought into via ambulance. The second highest is if you pay cash in advance, and the best deal of all is if you have Blue Cross Blue Shield.
Because they have a big contract with them?
Yeah, that's right. But the point of it is for each procedure
at their hospital, they have a price list, and there's three different columns. Three different prices.
Mm.
Now,
that's pretty odd.
I called hospital victims.
Right.
And they tell me, no, it's not.
It's common?
It's very, very common. And some of these private hospitals owned by the giant hospital corporations charge 2.5 to 3 times as much as the Mayo Clinic does. No kidding. Counselor, hang on, if you would, because when we come back, I have something else that'll just turn you like you can't believe right after this on TalkStar.
Say, do you or a member of your family suffer from acne? Do you take prescription drugs and get little or no relief? Is your skin always dry and itching and peeling due to the side effects of chemicals and drugs? Do you have trouble looking in the mirror and being happy with what you see? Do you avoid going out in the world due to your acne? Are you spending ridiculous amounts of money with little or no results? Well, you may find relief. Relief is available to most sufferers online at healthstarproducts.com. It's guaranteed, or you get your money back, and you've got 90 days to decide. Look it up for yourself online at HealthStar Products, H-E-A-L-T-H, HealthStarProducts.com. Go to www.HealthStarProducts.com and find out about the acne program. Find out if it works for you or a member of your family. If it doesn't, you get your money back. I've been reading online about a drug-free home treatment program that suggests you can be asthma-free. It's a program designed by an ex-asthmatic who claims she cured her own asthma. It's based on a little-known but astounding clinical trial at a major hospital. What would you give to be free of asthma, asthma symptoms, and sinus and allergy symptoms, to breathe easily, freely, naturally, in a relaxed way? This drug-free method, proven by clinical trials, is guaranteed, or you get your money back, and you have 90 days to decide. Get to your computer now and go to HealthStarProducts.com. That's www.HealthStarProducts.com. Read about the asthma program, and if it doesn't do what it says it'll do for you, you get your money back, and you've got 90 days to decide. Go to HealthStarProducts.com.
Attorney Ray Boris with us. The book is Insult to Injury. His website is Boris, BORUR-HIS-WOLFSON.com. Boris-WOLFSON.com. Counselor, here's one more for you. Let's say that you are an American taxpayer, and God forbid you have no health insurance, and you have an unexpected hospitalization. Or even if you do have health insurance. But let's say you don't. And the next thing is you get home and you're back up on your feet, you're well again. And the bills start rolling in and they're 50 grand. I know one man was in the hospital for 4 hours, 4 hours to have a tube changed for his a kidney drainage system. And the total bill was $25,000. Okay? 4 hours. Long story short, you come home, you're uninsured. And now the bills start piling in, and they total up to $50,000. You now have to file bankruptcy. With the new bankruptcy law, you know that you are an indentured servant. And you don't even question the charges because of the fact you get the high uninsured rate, okay?
Mm-hmm.
But if you're an illegal immigrant, and you have exactly the same set of circumstances, you get free care. You pay nothing.
Well, you know, the one of the problems that you're pointing out, and it's a problem that kind of really hits the elderly, is if you have assets, then you're going to have to pay medical expenses and deductibles and so on until you don't have any assets anymore. So you save for your whole life, and then you watch your life savings dribble away in health expenses for prescription drug benefits and everything else, and it's only when you have nothing left that you can really start getting some medical care other than your Medicare benefits that you're entitled to beyond a certain age. It's kind of a crazy system. The whole system is. The problem that I have with it, I mean, there are a lot of problems that go beyond insult to injury. The problem I have is that I really can't even believe, even after all this litigation, I don't know even know how many cases we've handled, I can't even believe that this company was ordered to reopen 215,000 claims and they were fined $15 million, which to them is like, you know, a stop sign violation to your listeners and to
right.
me.
Right.
But fined $15 million, and they were ordered to reopen and reexamine these claims with absolutely no outside oversight whatsoever. Nobody looking over their shoulder.
Right.
The same people who denied them in the first place,
right.
given the right to review it the second time. Why? Because insurance commissioners made this ruling from the three states where the three companies' main subsidiaries are headquartered. Provident, which is from Tennessee, Unum, which is from Maine, and Paul Revere, which is from Massachusetts. So those three insurance commissioners got together and they said to each other, look, you know, this is getting serious. It's been on 60 Minutes. It's been on Dateline. We're looking like fools. We're not doing anything about it. We're going to have to do something. So they cooked up in cahoots with the insurance company a settlement agreement. And that settlement agreement called for the fine that I just mentioned and for the approach to reopening these claims. And that's the way it's unfolding. John Garamendi in California, the insurance commissioner in this state, said, nothing doing. I'm not going to go along with that. And he refused. And John Morrison in Montana did the same thing as Garamendi. But we wrote a letter to every insurance commissioner in America and asked them not to agree to this settlement unless there were modifications, major modifications to it. And we didn't get a single response except from Garamendi and Morrison. So the whole system, whether you're talking about the regulatory agencies or whether you're talking about the ERISA nonsense, the green light for fraud, or whether you're talking about state regulations that give a green light also to insurance companies do whatever they want with regulations written by the company lobbyists,
right.
It's such a mess. It's so outrageous. It's so corrupt. People have no idea that this is going on. And I'm fortunate, I'm very honored to have an endorsement from Senator Ted Kennedy of my book and of the reforms that we're going to be seeking. I've been in touch with John McCain's office in Arizona, and hopefully he will also join in this effort. So I really want to get to work and roll up our sleeves and change the situation. And I think there are some good people like McCain and Kennedy who are going to be willing to carry the ball on this. I certainly hope so.
I just wonder where they were when the first ERISA deal got passed.
Well, you know, I gotta tell you, the first ERISA deal wasn't a bad deal. You know what it was? The Employment Retirement Income Security Act to
yeah.
protect employees against their retirement
yeah.
income
but they got
being taken away by corporations with their mergers and their acquisitions and their disappearing act.
But this
so that what was happening, the corporations were saying, well, you've got a retirement
right.
bundle here. Well, unfortunately, you no longer work for X Corporation. Now you work for Y Corporation.
Yeah.
We took over X Corporation, and you don't get any benefits
yeah.
anymore.
But
Congress, in an effort to put a stop to that, passed the Employment Retirement Income Security Act. And the Supreme Court got its hand on this conservative Supreme Court, the pro-business Supreme Court
yeah.
that can see no evil that any corporation would ever engage in, got its hands on it and turned it upside down and inside out. Instead, it became the Employment Insecurity Act because they told employees that they had no protections anymore from fraudulent activities by insurance companies. It makes no sense. The decision makes no sense. I'll tell you why it doesn't make any sense, in addition to what I've already said. The reason is because there are no federal insurance regulations. Why? Because of the McCarran-Ferguson Act, passed again
right.
by the insurance company lobbyists.
I'm Chuck Carter saying, help out where you can, ladies and gentlemen. You know of all the charities. They're everywhere. Red Cross, Salvation Army, you name it. Do what you can. And be good to your neighbor. God save America. God bless America and our troops. Amen.
The views expressed on this podcast are not necessarily the views of the good folks from goodpoliticsradio.com. However, we do welcome your comments on this podcast, and we would love to hear from you. This is Tim Loomis. from goodpoliticsradio.com. Thank you for listening.